It is now day 12 of Mauna Loa's eruption in Hawaii, and for those of you who live on the island, I have some very positive news. For more than a week, lava from a fissure, specifically Fissure 3 in Mauna Loa's northeast rift zone, had been slowly advancing towards a major road on the island which connects Hilo with the western side of the island. It had looked that this lava flow would almost certainly flow onto and cut off the road, causing a major problem. However, as of December 8th at 9:30 a.m. local time on the Big Island, the main lava flow advancing towards the road almost completely ceases activity. While the lava in this lobe is still molten, and per the US Geological Survey, it might continue to advance at a very slow speed as the lava flow cools. For all intents and purposes, the lava flow is officially no longer active. Its furthest advance stands at 1.7 miles or 2.8 kilometers from the road. This change was triggered by two factors. First, several lava flow breakouts occurred and only flowed up to 2.75 miles or 4.4 kilometers from Fissure 3. This previously dominant channel is unlikely to reactivate for the remainder of the eruption. The second reason for this sudden change was a dramatically reduced supply of molten rock erupting at Fissure 3. Whereas at 6:50 a.m. local time on the Big Island on December 7th, the erupting vent looked like this with still persistent lava fountains, as of 6:38 a.m. local time on the Big Island on December 9th, it now looks like this. While the reduced supply of magma could indicate a temporary blockage that might eventually clear, I think it is more likely that Mauna Loa's eruption is showing the beginning of its end. And this coincides with the fact that the amount of sulfur dioxide Mauna Loa's eruption and its lava flows produced decreased from 120,000 tons a day on December 4th to 30,000 tons a day on December 8th. Regardless, the lava channels close to Fissure 3 are still erupting as of the writing of this video, occasionally producing what is known as a lava boat. Per a direct quote from the US Geological Survey, lava boats can form when portions of the cone or lava channel break away and are rafted downstream. Several of my viewers were wondering how the ongoing eruption compares in volume to other well-known eruptions in the 2020s. As of December 8th at 10 a.m. local time, lava flows from Mauna Loa's eruption had covered a total area of 17.7 square miles, or 45.8 square kilometers. Although an official figure on the total amount of erupted lava has not been released, based on the total area lava has covered, I estimate that somewhere around 229 million cubic meters of lava has erupted. This is greater than 111 million cubic meters Kilauea has produced in its now more than 14-month-long volcanic eruption, which is still ongoing. It is also a larger figure than the 150 million cubic meters of lava that Fagradalsfjall volcano in Iceland erupted in 2021. And it is also greater than the approximately 190 million cubic meters of lava that the 2021 eruption of the Cumbre Vieja volcano in the Canary Islands produced. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's top supporters on YouTube via YouTube members and patrons on Patreon.